Welcome back, everyone. I'm Jordan Giesige, and this is The Limiting Factor. Earlier this year, Elon said that he's been thinking about the fastest way to bring a terawatt of compute online, which is roughly equivalent to the total power output of the U.S. electrical grid. The question is, why does Elon want to build that much compute, and what's his larger vision? In short, it comes down to creating the abundance necessary to build an exciting, sci-fi-inspired future. Today, I'll explain how extraordinary amounts of power and compute will get us there. Before we begin, a special thanks to my Patreon supporters, YouTube members, and Twitter subscribers, as well as Rebellionaire.com. They specialize in helping investors manage concentrated positions. Rebellionaire can help with covered calls, risk management, and creating a money master plan from your financial first principles. There are two types of compute tasks needed for artificial intelligence: training and inference. Training compute means taking huge amounts of data, think millions of books worth of data, and processing it with the largest supercomputers on Earth until it creates what you might think of as a digital brain, or AI model. The more data and compute used to create that AI model, the better it becomes at recognizing patterns and solving problems, meaning it becomes more intelligent, which, in turn, makes the AI model more useful. As a result, there's strong demand for training compute, even at eye-watering prices of tens of billions of dollars per data center. In the pre-deep learning era, training compute doubled every 21.6 months. In the deep learning era, which started in 2010, training compute has been doubling every 6 months. Looking at a real-world example, XAI's Colossus 1 data center, which was completed this year, used 230,000 GPUs and around 300 megawatts of power in total. Their Colossus 2 data center, which I expect to be completed next year, will use 1 million GPUs that have about 4.4 times more training compute than the Colossus 1 GPUs and require about 3 gigawatts of power in total. That means the Colossus 2 data center will have around 19 times more compute and require 10 times more power, and there will only be about 12 to 18 months between their completion dates. The second type of compute is inference compute. That's where the AI model that was created during training is installed in a data center or device and used to answer questions or identify images, for example. Inference requires much less compute and power than training. That's for the same reason it can take months to learn a piano piece, but once it's learned, it's easy to play. Recall is less effort than learning. However, although the compute per task for inference is low, the total compute required for inference is still extraordinary. Why is that? Because AI is being adopted at a faster rate than any other technology in history. It took Google Search 11 years to hit 365 billion annual searches, and it only took ChatGPT 2 years. The latest information is that it's now around 900 billion searches per year for ChatGPT alone, and that doesn't include the dozens of other AI models that have emerged since 2023. Now that we understand the types of compute required for AI and why there's so much demand for that compute, it still doesn't fully explain why Elon wants to build 1 terawatt of it, which, despite large demands from training and inference, seems excessive. For reference, estimates are that by 2028, the power demand from AI data centers for the entire world will only be around 80 gigawatts. By that point, all AI models combined will likely be processing as many queries as Google is per year. So for Elon's companies alone, at some point in the future, the target is 12 times more power than the entire world will be consuming from all AI service providers in 2028. Is that realistic? Yes, and in fact, it's a drop in the bucket compared to the AI compute that humanity will demand in the long run. Let's take a closer look. AI will give every human on the planet tools, assistants, and robots to outsource work to at low cost. That will massively increase the amount of useful work each person can do, resulting in a fundamental increase in real wealth, or GDP, by trillions of dollars. That's because inflation-adjusted GDP is a fundamental measure of the amount of useful work done by humans. On that note, AI will likely cause deflation because it will increase the supply of mental and physical labor in the economy at low cost, which will lower prices. And of course, lower prices mean increased demand. Translation, AI will create abundance because everything will get cheaper. In fact, the price of everything will get so low over time that the demand will be near infinite. That's because humans have infinite wants, and the only thing that throttles that demand is paying the price for the things we want. And when we get what we want, we quickly become acclimated to it and want more. Just like a caveman couldn't fathom all the goods and services we have today, we can't fathom all the goods and services people will have 20 years from now. Would you stop at a 2,000-square-foot stick-built home if you could build a 2,000-square-foot home made of solid limestone for the same price? If that health test you've been putting off cost $200 instead of $2,000, would you do it immediately and several other tests while you were at it? And how much would the limestone home and cheaper medical testing improve your safety and health, allowing you to be a productive member of society for longer? Humans are valuable, and when they're safer and healthier, that has a real impact on GDP. That's not to mention the economic and personal benefits of having homes that last thousands of years rather than a few hundred years. Beyond lowering the cost of goods and services, unlike any other technology that humanity has ever invented, AI itself will also be able to invent new technologies. And new technologies are the primary driver of all economic growth, because they create entirely new classes of goods and services. For example, discovering new physics and engineering solutions could allow us to travel to and colonize Earth orbit, other planets, and even other solar systems more quickly and at lower costs, creating an interplanetary economy. Instead of having ocean-going yachts and private islands, the ultra-rich are going to have space yachts and space stations. That is, AI is going to usher in an era of abundance, and the fundamental driver of cost will be the cost of power and compute that provides it. So whether you're an investor or generally interested in humanity and a brighter future, the question becomes, what person, company, or companies will be able to provide more powerful AI compute, faster and at lower cost, to feed the limitless wants and needs of humanity? My bet is on Elon and his companies, like Tesla and XAI. That's because not only is Elon targeting 1 terawatt of compute, he's lining up the entire tech stack to achieve it, from the batteries and other infrastructure needed to house the compute, to the computer chips that make up the compute itself. And 1 terawatt of compute is really just the first order of magnitude that Elon's got his mind on. He's talked many times about the Kardashev scale and becoming a Type 1 civilization. What does that mean? The Kardashev scale measures a civilization's technological advancement based on power use, and it matters because the more power a civilization produces, the more work it can do, and presumably the cheaper it can do it thanks to economies of scale. A Type 1 civilization controls all power on a planetary scale. In our case, the Earth. A Type 2 civilization controls all power on a stellar scale. In our case, the Sun. And a Type 3 civilization controls all the power at a galactic scale. In our case, the Milky Way. Earth is around Type 0.7, not yet Type 1, but that makes it sound like we're close to a Type 1 civilization. We're not. The Kardashev scale is logarithmic. Humans currently control about 18 terawatts of power, and we have to reach 10,000 terawatts. So we're only about 0.18% the way to a Type 1 civilization. That is, type 1 power consumption is so incomprehensibly large that Elon had to pick a power target that was more pragmatic. 1 terawatt is that number. It's a crazy number for Elon's companies to aspire to, but still comprehensible and achievable, making it an inspiring and motivating target for Elon and his data center and energy teams to hit. For reference, total global solar panel production alone is at least 600 gigawatts, and it's growing at double-digit percentages. If the growth of solar production continued at 20%, and Elon's companies on average used 5% of that production, or 30 gigawatts and growing, they could build out 1 terawatt of power generation in about a decade. I think 20 to 25 years is more likely. But the point here is to show that it's possible to install 1 terawatt of power generation in a reasonable time frame to feed the growing needs of compute. As I said earlier, xAI's Colossus 1 data center uses about 0.3 gigawatts of power, and their next data center, Colossus 2, will likely install 3 gigawatts worth of compute in the next year. That is, a 10x growth in power consumption in about 12 to 18 months. Making another 10x growth in the next few years to 30 gigawatts mind-boggling, but on the right trajectory. With that said, it's not as simple as just buying the solar panels, and they may not be the cheapest and most scalable option in the short term. So, in the next video, I'll get into the brass tacks of how Elon and his companies could actually execute on Elon's goal of 1 terawatt of compute. If you enjoyed this video, please consider supporting the channel by using the links in the description. Also, consider following me on X. I often use X as a testbed for sharing ideas, and X subscribers, like my Patreon supporters, generally get access to my videos a week early. On that note, a special thanks to my YouTube members, X subscribers, and all the other patrons listed in the credits. I appreciate all of your support, and thanks for tuning in.